Hey there! If you are a regular viewer of this channel, you should now have a fair idea of how rockets work and how they take people from Earth into space. This video will look into a new area of astronautical engineering, which deals with how objects in space move around under the influence of gravity, shortly put as orbital mechanics. Let's get spacey. While orbits in nature are ellipses, these shapes have complex mathematics around them, and so, for a conceptual understanding of basic orbital mechanics, a theoretical circular orbit will suffice. The first equation that comes up here is Sir Isaac Newton's Universal Theory of Gravity. Let's start off by going through these different terms with the help of this diagram. So here we have two objects with masses m1 and m2. And they are separated from their centers by a distance r. We also have a gravitational constant that we believe is constant for all objects in the universe. The key thing to take away from this is that there is an inverse square law in play here with the force between the two objects and the distance between them. So, if you move twice as far away, you only have quarter the gravitational attraction. Now, using this equation, and another one you should be familiar with, let's get into orbital velocity. Now to understand more about orbits, we need to get some more equations into the mix. Let's start with Newton's second law, which is F is equal to ma. Rearranging both of these equations here to get F over m on one side, we find that the acceleration is equal to force over mass, which is also equal to this equation right here. Now, a third equation that also applies to this case is that of centripetal acceleration from high school kinematics. Now, this here means that the acceleration of the object in orbit is the square of its velocity over the radius of the orbit. Now, setting the rearranged equation 1 equal to equation 3, we get this formula for the orbital velocity of an object, which is equal to the gravitational constant g times the mass of the large object that is being orbited around divided by the radius of the object in orbit. The key thing to note here is that orbital velocity is independent of the mass of the object in orbit itself. And if you really think about it, is what enables activities like docking of two spacecrafts with different masses, such as the International Space Station and a Dragon capsule, in the same orbit. Now, this concept can be extended to reach conclusions about the relationship between orbital periods and orbital radii, and how that also creates different types of orbits. But that, my friends, is for our next video. Until then, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel, comment below with any questions or suggestions. I'll see you soon, and until then, stay spacey.